The pursuit of knowing was freedom to me, the right to declare your own curiosities and follow them through all manner of books. I was made for the library, not the classroom. The classroom was a jail of other people's interests. The library was open, unending, free. Here, hope you guys are doing well, and if my channel can inspire you to do any one thing, I hope that it is to read more. In fact, literature of any kind is knowledge that we are so privileged to absorb with our gift of study. And as my favorite Chinese philosopher Lao Tzu says, mastering others is strength, but mastering yourself is true power. And in the same vein, each book that you pick up and read should be treated as a gift that can help you better yourself in every single way. A good book can enhance your vocabulary, it can improve your writing, it can expand your mind about thoughts and philosophies that you have never considered, and most importantly, it can give you a good heart and a clear mind whenever you may be feeling misunderstood, alone, or in need of inspiration. That being said, I wanted to take the time today to share with you how and why I read in the hopes that I can maybe inspire some of you to pick up the same hobby. Okay, first the how part. Follow me. Arm yourself with a wonderful spot, a notepad, and a book of your choice. The combination of the three, along with time and dedication, will change your life, I promise you. As you read, highlight words, phrases, and fragments of language that draw you in, and then in the composition book, don't be afraid to write them down. Play with those words and sentences to maybe form your own, and most importantly, always challenge yourself to try and express the same idea in different language. Also, you should never be afraid to put the book down, take a moment to yourself, and really ponder the words that your author has written. Question his or her prose and try and connect your upbringing to the story that he or she has contrived. Mix those realities and finally let the book teach you something by having this deep and amazing effect on you. Then do this over and over and over and over again until finally you have reaped the mental benefits that reading has to offer. Ultimately, you will realize that with each book read, you are closer, but never quite there in the quest to master yourself. And you will soon realize that the quest is supposed to be endless. In fact, this is what makes reading such a wondrous and timeless process. So, next time you have a moment to yourself, don't go to your phone or your computer. Instead, pick up a great book and get absolutely lost in it. Let the beauty of language wash over you and create images and realities and kingdoms in your head and witness the human experience through a different set of eyes, or in this case, words. As always, thanks so much for watching. I hope that this video has convinced you in some way, maybe to take up reading as a hobby, and as you churn through books and communicate with people who might be dead for centuries, understand that you are becoming more intelligent, more emotionally aware, and part of a very unique experience shared by authors and their readers. As always, thanks for watching, and I'll catch you guys in the next one.